Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about what is atomic radius and what are the trends, or we could say what are the variations that we could see in the property atomic size when it comes to the periodic table. So now we are going to talk about ionic radius and its variation or and its trends that we are observing in the periodic table. So what are those? Let us talk about that. So let us see what is actually ionic radius. As I have mentioned earlier also, that it is the distance between the nucleus and the outermost valence shell of an ion. So as I have mentioned earlier also, that the ion is been now distributed into two parts, as you know, that is one is cation and one is anion. And that what we have got to know, we have got to know that the cation is smaller than that of its parent ion. When it comes to an anion, anion is having a more size compared to that of its parent atom. So now in this case, what we are going to talk about, we are going to talk about the trends or the variation that we observe. And what are the variation that we observe in periods and in groups? Let us talk about that also. So ionic size is similar to that of the atomic size. So it is similar to that of the atomic size that we have did earlier also. So atomic size and the ionic size, they don't differ a lot when it comes to the trend. How? Because atomic size is nothing but when it comes to the distance between the nucleus and the outermost shell or the valence shell. But ionic size is just for the distance between the nucleus and the outermost shell of an ion, and that can be more or that can be less also compared to that of an atom. So let's talk about the first thing, that is what will happen when we are talking about the trend or the variation that we observe in period. So whenever we say that what would be the atomic, what would be the ionic size in terms of period, then what we see is in the period, as the atomic number increases, the atomic size also increases. So therefore, this says that atomic number increases and gradually in period. But when we are talking about ion, so basically when it comes to ion also, again we would say that the atomic number will be nothing but it will be nothing the number of protons that is present in an atom or present in an ion, because the number of protons will be the same in that case. So therefore, if the number of atom increases, it will increase gradually and we could see that the atomic size will go on decreasing. And moreover, suppose if it has a positive charge, or when we are talking about a cation, so cation will have one electron less, at least one electron less. So what will happen in that case? In that case, the atomic size will reduce more compared to that of an atom. So this will lead to the atomic size to decrease more effectively when it comes to a period. And that's the reason the atomic size, or we could say for ionic size in period, actually ionic size decreases. Because even the nuclear charge will go on increasing, because if the electrons are being removed from the atom so as to form an cation, so in that case what happens is the nuclear charge will increase and the atomic or ionic size will go on decreasing. So similarly, when we are talking about in a group, so in group what happens? Again, when we are talking about atomic size or ionic size in this case, so again it will be similar to that of the atomic size that we have observed, because as the number of electrons goes on increasing, or as the number of electrons are being added in the elements or the atoms of the element when we come to up to down the group, so the number of electrons goes on increasing, and because of that the number of shells will also go on increasing. But when we are talking about an cation, again it will be showing the similar behavior that of the atomic trend that we have saw in our earlier lecture. That is, the size of the atomic size will go on increasing. But similarly, in that case, in this case also, the ionic size will go on increasing when it comes to down the group. So this trend will make us to know that it is very much similar to that of the atomic size. So therefore, in this case, we could conclude that the atomic number goes on increasing, but talking about the ionic size. So ionic size in groups also goes on increasing. So this will go on increasing, similar to that of the atomic size. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly. So you'll share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.